During an interview this week on the Dan Bongino Show, Donald Trump demanded immediate debates with President Biden. That's right, Donald Trump, the guy who, by the way, has been avoiding debates all throughout the Republican primary and has even hinted that he's not going to participate in the presidential debates this year, is now suddenly demanding that we go ahead and do the presidential debates because, by God, he is ready to go. This is what Trump had to say. He said, "I'd like to call for immediately debates. I'd like to debate him now because we should debate. We should debate for the good of the country." Because apparently if you just say the word debate in every sentence that you say, it makes you sound like you actually have a reason for wanting to debate. No, not really, but okay. And President Biden, when asked about this when he was in Nevada this week, President Biden responded and said, "Well, if I were him, I'd want to debate me too. He's got nothing else to do." Why can't we have more of that, Biden? Like the funny, quick-witted guy. Like, I like that Biden. I don't like the Biden who said that in 2021 he was talking to a guy who died in 1996. You know, that gaffe this week is a pretty big one blowing up everywhere. That's not good. I like funny, quick-witted Biden who can take a quick jab at Trump and move on. And let's be real here. Donald Trump doesn't have anything better to do right now except await his criminal trials. But I gotta say, in this particular instance, Biden kind of laughing it off, Trump demanding debates, I'm kind of with Trump on this. I want to go ahead and see debates. I think we should do that. Biden performed exceptionally well against Donald Trump in the 2020 debates. He absolutely hammered him. Trump did not win those debates, and Biden did. And if we can go ahead and get that now, if we can have Biden get up on stage and beat the hell out of Donald Trump 6 or 7 times before the election instead of the standard 3, I think that's powerful. I think it's useful. I think it's going to help remind voters, because this would be, you know, on primetime television. I think it would remind a lot of people that tune out of politics except for things like debates, it would remind them how horrible Trump is. See, we take for granted, because we do this every day. I sit here and I talk every single day about politics. But I even take for granted the fact that 99% of the population out there, 98 maybe, they don't pay attention to this stuff every day. They're not avid news consumers. You take Fox News, even as the highest rated cable news station in the country, their overall daily audience is literally 1% of the population. So we've got maybe 95% of the public that's not getting this national political news every single day. They don't care about it. They care about their actual daily lives. They tune in when it's a big presidential race, right? And they're starting to tune in more, but debates would get them tuned in now. And they wouldn't have to wait till September or October to remember what a horrible piece of crap Donald Trump is, because they're not hearing it from me every day. I mean, I'd love it if they would tune in every day and hear that, but they're not. They're not hearing it from David Pakman every day, or Sam Cedar, or any of the other folks out there doing this every day. They're just going about their lives, not consuming political news. So they have to be reminded, and the most effective way to reach them is with nationally televised presidential debates starting now. So again, probably the first and only time ever, I think we should do Trump's idea instead of Biden just laughing it off. I love the way he laughed it off. I think it was clever and fun, but I also think we need those debates now. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.